She got on the bus. She was made up rather heavily. She was dressed very beautifully, and she was busy talking to our counselors. We come to the Dutch border, and two Nazis in uniform screamed into the bus and pointed to three children and said, "You, you, and you, come out, open your suitcases. And if we find anything other than clothes, you all go back." Well, this woman became very active. She, all of a sudden, she went out. She offered them cigarettes. She lit the cigarettes and popped them into their mouth. And they were charmed by her because she was a beautiful lady. And she offered them candy. And she was so busy flirting with them, and they were so busy flirting back, they didn't look too closely at the suitcases. And they said, "Okay, close it, get back on the bus." And she's busy talking to them, and the Nazis motioned with a hand for the border, the German border, to lift it for us to go through. And as that was lifted, she jumped on the bus, the doors closed, and we rode through, and we got safely into Holland. The first thing this woman did, she took out a tissue and wiped all this makeup off. And I remember her sitting back. It was like when you have two seats, like a little jump seat in the middle of the bus. And she said, "Whew, that was a hard one." And I would like to, just for a moment, jump.
Do you remember her name?
Yes. Well, I didn't know it then. I was going to say, I will jump. I found out who she was and what her name was. Her name was Wilhelmina Weissmuller. Wilhelmina Weissmuller was a non-Jewish Dutch woman that was totally, and her husband was a very prominent banker. She was a humanitarian, and she was totally appalled by the way Hitler and the Germans were treating Jews. It's not that she was so much in love with Jews. It's just that she felt it's unfair. You don't treat other people like that, no matter who they are. And she made it her mission to get as many children out of Germany as possible. We found out many years later that she met the highest, she was able to meet some of the highest German Nazis, like Himmler, for instance. And she was one of the people that managed to convince England to accept 10,000 Jewish children. The stipulation was that the children had to be above the age of 14. And in order, and they tried to, and England agreed to it, provided the Germans, the Nazis, said it's okay. Well, the Nazis said, "No, it's not okay." They weren't interested. Well, she managed to convince them. She was a very powerful, very determined woman. And she managed to convince them to let these children out.